A fascinating piece, and this is a big debate in Camp Clinton. You know, she campaigned in Kentucky, Alison Grimes lost. She campaigned in Iowa, Bruce Braley lost. She campaigned in North Carolina, Kay Hagan lost. It's not Hillary Clinton's fault, but she did give her brand to those candidates. They didn't do that well. Was 2014 and more Republicans in Washington, is that good for Hillary Clinton or bad for Hillary Clinton?
I think it's a mixed bag. It's both good and bad. I think in some ways it's good, right, because you have a Republican-controlled Congress, and that makes it really easy for Secretary Clinton to run against Washington because it's the opposite party. She can say, look, these guys are not, you know, she can draw a very sharp contrast. And I think it also makes it easier to separate herself from the president because there's certainly, everyone seems to agree on both parties that President Obama's, you know, bad approval ratings have played a serious role in, you know, Democrats' failure in these midterms. So it makes it easier to draw those two contrasts. I think it puts a lot more pressure on her because the party is, everyone is stressed out in the Democratic Party. They're trying to unpack why this happened. And a lot of them are turning to Hillary as someone that could come and save them. And that's a rough position to be in. You never want to have expectations too high before you announce.
She is, in essence, is she not, Ed, the leader of the party now? A lot of Democrats, whether it's fair or unfair, whether it's right or wrong, a lot of the congressional Democrats and Democrats out in the country blame the president. They blamed the president. They didn't like it. They thought it was a bad enough year anyway, and then he said, I'm not on the ballot, but my policies are. That was in every Republican ad everywhere. Is she not de facto? There'd be no loyalty to the president, I don't think. We saw this happen to George W. Bush after the 2006 midterms where Democrats, he asked them to say, you know, say good morning. Right. He asked Republicans, Bush did, to say good morning, and they wouldn't talk back to him.
Yeah, I think she is, in a sense, if not the leader, she's certainly the leader in waiting. And part of why she's a winner after all this is because so many other Democrats lost, and because other Democrats who had ties to people who lost lost, she is now essentially it. And it would be very difficult, especially for someone from the left, to challenge her at all.
And she's going to have to come out, and just like the president did, and give her explanation for why this happened. And that's going to be a fascinating moment. And I think it's one everyone is waiting to see.
And a lot of people suggesting maybe she should speed up her timetable.